Review Magazine, India's largest solar media. Joining us today is Mr. Bharat Singh, who is the Head of Sales and Marketing, Indore. Welcome, sir.
Hi, thank you.
Please tell us something about your company.
Myself, Bharat Singh, Head for Sales and Marketing in India. Doi Motors was formed in 2000. Actually, initially, manufacturing the molding machines and the molding parts. In 2007, we formed the Inverter Technology Co. Limited company,
okay,
where we started manufacturing of inverters and also inverters like on-grid, hybrid, and the micro inverters. So it is situated in Ningbo, which is one of the largest port in world, and we have manufacturing capacity of $1 million of worth of inverters per day. Manufacturing capacity, we don't tell it in gigawatt or megawatt. The reason is there will be different ratings, so we tell it in the value, that is 0.5 for on-grid and 0.5. You can consider $1 million per day. And to tell more about the company, we have very good R&D facility in China with PhD holders and engineers for future of renewable energy. And to be tell about the products, we have the hybrid, which is very new and required for the future, because battery storage is the future for the renewable rooftop and the domestic and industrial market, which has lot of advantages. And our Doi Inverters has very unique selling points and also features, which is fast, safe, reliable, and smart and intelligent inverter.
So what are those USPs, the unique selling point that you
have? Yes, unique selling point would be we have very less switching time in the hybrid inverters, and we have 6 time interval for the battery charging and discharging. We have very high charging and discharging current with the batteries. So these are few unique points.
You also discussed about the R&D. You have a great team there. Could you tell us more about it? And how much percentage of your total profits, in terms of your profit, how much percentage goes into R&D?
See, our managing director, he's a visionary guy who wants to have a future product which is to be reliable. So we invest a lot into the R&D. We can say about 30 to 40% of our revenue goes to R&D. So that's the thing, 30 to 40% of revenue goes to R&D.
Okay. So what are your top states where you have supplied the most products? And what are the top markets?
Yeah, see, the major market for us in inverters is China. China being the top installer. Second thing would be USA and South Africa, African regions. In Asia, yes, India being very potential market, we have been in India from past 4-5 years, and we have launched recently these hybrid inverters in India just 6 months back. So we are expecting very good revenue from hybrid inverters.
Okay. The 450 gigawatt capacity that was promised by the government by 2030, and with the COP commitments coming in of having net zero emission by 2070, where do you think India stand right now, and how far do we have to go?
The target what India has set of 450 gigawatt, it's challenging but not impossible. The reason is we can see a lot of manufacturing of the modules have come up in India, and inverters are also coming up, but it has some of lagging, in the quality control or some other aspects. But achieving this target is challenging but possible.
What are your thoughts on the BIS and other tariffs?
On the tariffs part, yes, as we see, the prices of the products are going down. So tariffs are also going down, but at certain stage, it has to be constant. That's a major debate to happen in coming days, because as the products are going down, the tariff shouldn't go down, because there will be a lot of impact on the EPCs and the developers to have their revenues. So okay. We say that to have a constant tariffs.
So basically, it's going to disincentivize.
Yes, true. Yeah. Yes.
Wait for the
agreed.
Developers and EPCs.
Yeah.
Okay. On that note, I would like to know about your opinions on Make in India. Toy is a Chinese company.
Yeah.
I would like to know
your opinion. Yes, I can tell you in the two parts. One is like model manufacturing. So model manufacturing in India is like seen like very good interest and also like very good response from the clients. And India has also seen like very good experience in manufacturing of module. But when it comes to inverter manufacturing as a like Make in India, Made in India and Make in India, there is like a lot of difference on it. So a lot of companies, yes, they buy the components from China and assemble it in India.
Yes.
But it's lagging on the quality control. What happens is, China being like very big manufacturer of the inverters and modules, they are bred into it. So they have like a lot of technologies and the day-to-day they know how to handle the situations in manufacturing. But like in India, it's lagging in the inverters and better like maybe for at least for 5 years, like we can't see any inverter manufacturing in
but
India.
But I'm sure that there is a great scope of inverter manufacturing
it's there,
in India.
There is a scope. Most probably after a couple of years, we can see there might be a Chinese intervention in manufacturing of inverters in India.
Okay, so on that topic, would you like to highlight about the opportunities and challenges in India and in the domestic market?
Yes, see, the challenging and the advantage or disadvantage, I can tell about the disadvantage if inverters are manufactured in India. As I told, like there is no quality control, first of all, while assembling the inverters. So that will have a disadvantage of like having more rejection ratio of the inverters. That would be like a huge loss for the manufacturer who have put up a line for manufacturing. So this is the challenging, like to have very good quality control. And when it comes to disadvantage, like rejection ratio should reduce.
Okay. And opportunities?
Opportunities are there. So we need to just wait for some more years. Maybe once like Chinese have their footfall here in manufacturing, yes, then like we can see some more improvement and opportunities in India.
But I'm sure with Indian manufacturers, Indian manufacturers bucking up and you know pulling the socks up,
yes.
Doy is going to have a great competition.
Yeah,
as well.
There is a competition. Yes, like we will have that. Thing.
But I'm sure Doy is also prepared for it.
Yeah, we are prepared for all of this.
So, could you also talk about the impact of LCOE on your project?
Yes. See, about LCOE on the projects, like we have like a couple of points to talk. One is like we use this space vector with pulse modulation, which is the first in the technology, and we are the first one to use that. It actually reduces the voltage stress on the DC bus and increases the efficiency. So once the efficiency is increased, like you can see impact on LCOE, and we also see this three-level topology in our inverters. So these are all like the latest technologies which we are using in our inverters, and it has a like, great impact on LCOE.
Okay. What are your future expansion plans, especially?
Yes. See, when it comes to the future expansion, as I told, like we have $1 million of manufacturing capacity per day. We are actually having an expansion of another facility, manufacturing facility, which adds up like $2 million per day. So that is like one future expansion, and also like we are planning to have multiple products in the coming year, which will be launched in SNEC and REI.
Okay. Any concluding remarks that you would like to share with our viewers on our platform?
When it comes to the manufacturing part, yes, like India is lagging on the inverters. And when it comes to module, yes, like we are fully equipped, but we have like very good expertise in manufacturing of modules. But in inverters, like we are lagging behind the quality control. That like we need to catch up. And when it comes to the installations, yes, like we are seeing like very good installations. And by 2030, yes, this 450 gigawatt is like achievable with the grid challenge.
Okay, thank you so much for taking our time from your very busy schedule. We understand it's busy.
Thank you.